6 out of 10 young men are single. The disturbing reasons why.
Gee, oh, yeah. This is a little, listen, this whole article here is a little shamey. They're trying to shame men a little bit in this one.
Shame and blame.
Shame and blame.
Let's delve into it here. They're not getting jerked around by dating anymore. Well,
not getting jerked at all.
Not in the way that they want. New Pew Research Center data has found nowadays 63% of men under 30 are electively single, up from 51%, as we covered. Young men are watching a lot of social media. They're watching a lot of Orn Pay, and I think they're getting a lot of their needs met without having to go out.
Mm.
No, not really. I'm single. I'm 32. I occasionally like going out and talking to people.
But the thing is,
that almost is propaganda right there, in my opinion.
Yeah, they're putting all men in one basket as, like, you know, sexual deviants. And the reason we're not getting, you know, into relationships is because we're getting our needs met by pulling the skin off of our penises.
Yeah, I'm paying for the girlfriend experience on OnlyFans. Yeah. That's why I'm not trying to find an actual woman in real life. That makes sense.
How about the fact that it's just a terrible deal? Yeah. You know, if you look at all of the shit women put in their profiles that they want out of a man, like, quite literally, just for you to get a shot, you better be over 6 feet tall, you know, make over $100,000, have the perfect body, you know, already show up with a house and a car, or you're done.
Yep.
And how the fuck is putting all that work in just to get a size 18 who's had a parade of dicks run through her? Go to hell. You're not worth it.
You know what really screws me up about this? Pop, I'm sure you've shared this experience. It wasn't like that a decade, 2 decades, 3 decades ago. The 6 foot, six figures, all of that, you could be 5'7", 5'8", something like that. You could still find yourself, I mean, I don't know, maybe it's just my experience, but you could still find yourself a pretty decent looking girl, 5'9", even taller, who cares, right? But now it's such a different world. And this is where I've mentioned on my channel, I have a hard time relating, because I have a lot of younger guys that watch, and it doesn't compute to me, does not compute. When I was dating in my 20s, you could still find women, but I would say it changed, and this is just my guess. It changed around 2015, maybe earlier, 2012. But the advent of social media and Tinder and, you know, Chatterbait, OnlyFans, whatever you want to use, all of that has really changed things a lot.
Yeah, I would say from 2008 on.
2008?
Yeah, 2008. Yeah.
But you know, the guys,
keep going. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to step on.
The guys playing in this field right now, it just, like I said, for me, it's foreign, and I don't know how to, you know, reach across the table and shake their hand and say, yeah, I relate, man, because the women now just, again, like we're talking about, they can all get on Instagram and hang out with Kobe and get flown out to India or whatever. This isn't the experience of the women I was dating. Now, they were still crazy back then, but you still had a shot. Now they're one click away from a celebrity, and all of them are sharing the celebrities. It's insane.
Yeah, well, there's going to be a lot of women who are going to get the super gonorrhea, catch themselves some perpagon and syphilades. Because, listen, there's probably some heavy hitters at the top on the men's side. That's all they do is just bang women as many as they can. So,
yeah,
you're taking the chances.
And some of those antibiotics aren't working anymore.
No, they are not. You're going to get yourself a permanent dick worm.
This is where I need the soundboards for gonorrhea.
I knew.
All right. Let's see. Going back to the article here.
Waffles, anyone?
Yeah. Yeah, no kidding. Fear the syrup. I think that's starting to be a habit, the psychologist claimed. The new post-COOF numbers would surely back up previous research the pandemic has made, as we referred to as previously. Just half a single men who responded said they are looking for a committed relationship and or casual dates.
That's weird. Did they put casual dates and committed relationship in the same part of the poll? That's skewing things a little bit.
Listen, they don't want to tell the truth. There are wars. There's nothing in the dating market that benefits men except for, 5 to 30 seconds of "oh baby."
So here we go with the what you claim, Papa, the blame and shame part of the article. Now here we go. I see it. Says, but these statistics tell a sadder truth about this generation of men. NYU psych professor Niobe Way told the
outlet. Oh, okay.
We are in a crisis of connection, Way said. Disconnection from ourselves and disconnection from each other, and it's getting worse.
Yep.
Well, it's not like there was a certain event that started in 2019 that is still going on and still causing fear and all this other stupid shit,
It's not like fifth generational warfare where they actually tried to isolate people for 3 years. No, yeah. That didn't happen.
No. Six feet away, stay inside, don't do that.
Listen, the people who fell for that are the sheeple.
Mm-hmm.
Weak-minded individuals who would have called the cops and dropped a dime on Anne Frank.
Yep. Not wrong.
And listen, and keep that in the back of your mind when you deal with people in the future. You can always say, hey, what did you do during the lockdowns? If they say, well, I stayed at home, then you know exactly what you're dealing with.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Me, I went out and had fun.
So did I.
I continued working. It didn't change for me at all.
Yeah. They go on to say the male numbers come sharply juxtaposed to the 34% of women who under 30 now say they're single. I wonder why. Which has seen only a slight pandemic raise in that age group. Another factor at play might be the interest of women changing, especially as suitors the same age are becoming apparently less desirable.
Experts. No, that okay. That's been the same since the beginning of time. Pop, you want to jump in? I'm just going to shut up and let
Absolutely
you.
Absolutely correct. Now listen, men have historically been nothing but expendable from roughly 18 to about 35.
Yep.
Like the first category for draft is 18 to 24, then it's 25 to 30, 36 to 40, and then anything beyond 40, they've already dropped nukes and it's going off the fucking going off the rail. But men have always been at a disadvantage when it comes to this. Because you talk to these women, they literally look right through you, like you don't even exist if you're in your 20s. Unless you have, you're 6 feet, you got the mark of the beast. If you're one of those unfortunate individuals, you're literally you're not even a speed bump to them.
No, if you're lucky enough to be a chatter Tyrone, and I say lucky in quotes, you might have some fun in your 20s. But here's the bottom line: at the end of it, even the Chad and Tyrone is going to suffer from the consequences of women. Getting involved with them, going into relationships with them, and then wrecking balling their lives at the end of it. So is it even worth it? And a lot of guys will say, oh, no, I just pump and dump. That's fine. You're still going to get emotionally attached to that. She loves me. She's different one. And then she's going to steamroll through your life and you're still going to be wrecked. It's just not worth it, man. Yep. It really isn't.
And if you don't, and if you're a fool and don't wrap your tool, you end up with a dick worm.
And child support.
Or you got a parasite that's stuck to your back for 18 to 21 years, depending upon the state you happen to live in.
There it is.
Let's see. Another factor that at play, maybe the interests of women change. Okay. Yep. I read that one. Women would rather go to brunch with friends than have a horrible date. There's the issue.
Well, so says the cunt of 1,000 cocks.
That's a lie. They're going to brunch after getting their backs blown out at the club. Okay, yeah. So that's the hangover cure is brunch, right?
They're going to brunch to brag about the Chad Tyrone or you or Ray Ray that they ended up with behind the dumb cumster. Mm-hmm. That's exactly what they're doing.
They let both of us on the stream tonight.
It's all good. It's all good.
You got extra waffles tonight, but anyway, let's carry on.
The expectations of American men are also rising in the minds of women, according to masculinity expert and University of Akron professor Ronald Levant.
Okay.
I did not know that we needed experts in masculinity.
What makes you an expert? I just, you know,
I
need to email this guy.
He added that unfortunately so many men don't have more to give. Men are supposed to be providers and protectors. If we can provide you with a house over your head, whether it be a home, an apartment, or whatever, we make sure the fucking bills are paid. Someone breaks into the house or apartment, we have cordless hole punchers. Not in my case, you know, because I don't have the upper body strength or anything like that. We can beat the fuck out of someone. I have a cordless hole punchers for that. Provider, protector, check and check.
Mm-hmm. Hey, listen, you'd be surprised. I've seen wiry dudes do amazing shit when they need to.
Yeah, that's true. Those skinny ones are the ones you got to be afraid of.
This one kid, he was like 6 feet, 155 pounds. Some crazy shit was going down. He literally strapped a dude onto his fucking back and rappelled down a 150-foot cliff.
God damn.
There you go.
Hell yeah.
I couldn't even do that. I'm like, bravo. Adrenaline is a good thing, I guess.
Shout out to that guy. Fuck, I don't even know if I can.
All right, Jimmy, I am abstaining of any more waffles, so the floor is yours, sir.
But perhaps the largest issue now with young men, here we go with more blame and shame, one highly impacting their social abilities is that they are, as a whole, more lonely people than women.
Okay.
Here we go with the lonely thing. All right. Now, listen, just because you like solitude doesn't mean you have to be lonely. Mm-hmm. Now, do we get hit with bouts of loneliness from time to time? Of course, we're humans. Mm-hmm. That's just the way it is. But if you look throughout history, men have always really been okay, you know, dealing with life on a one-on-one basis.
Yeah.
Yep.
Well, the other thing is that they're flat out lying in this article. Lonely. Was that by choice? Did they just wake up one day and say, "Hey, you know what? I just kind of want to spend the rest of my life alone." I don't think any man really signed up for that. But when you have women that are, let's be quite frank, the girl next door has an OnlyFans account, right? I'm just saying hypothetically. I don't know the girl next door, but if I did, I'm sure she had an account. When all the women around you are e-thoughts and slurs, and you don't really have any options, it gets a little lonely out there because you can't find anyone of substance worth dating. That makes things a little bit lonely, but they don't want to tell you that. They don't want to say that they're intentionally promoting promiscuity and degeneracy in modern women and destroying the nuclear family. They don't want to talk about that. But the men are just lonely incels and they can't find any love. No. You're promoting degeneracy like it's no big deal. That's going to have repercussions.
Absolutely correct. Wow, you said that quite well. I like it.
I get spun up myself sometimes.
Pop, you really need to jump in Rhino's streams every now and then. He gets to going.
I do.
All right.
It's good times.
Right. We can do that.
Let's see. In the early 1990s, 55% of men were reported to have six or more close friends. That percentage dwindled down to 27 in 2021, according to the American Perspectives Survey. Now, 15% of men they have no close personal friendships, according to the survey. My question is: every time I see a survey, is how many people were surveyed? If it's if it's like 1,000 to 3,000, your survey is bullshit, in my opinion.
It was just 10 people, Jimmy. No big deal.
But you also got to take into account a lot of these young guys now. literally sat behind a computer or a gaming console for most of their childhood. And that's where you meet and you make those lifelong friends.
Watch Grunt Speak live every Tuesday and Thursday at 8 p.m. Eastern. And if you want to join Pop for Supporter Sundays, go to redonkulous.com/donate and make a monthly pledge. A link is in the meat gazer box.